Okay, so setup wise now, certainly that tilted feeling there is going to be something just to keep sort of progressing with that. I would try, if you can, as we said, when you hold the golf club, when you put the first hand on the golf club, putting your left hand, your left thumb across to the side, as it would naturally hang, your left arm kind of hangs from the shoulders, our thumbs kind of point diagonally across your body, 45 degrees. You don't want to have your thumbs pointing this way or twisted out this way, they hang in there. So then put the club in that left hand at that angle, that will get your left hand a bit stronger, position the club by the ball, and then the right shoulder kind of comes under, and you get yourself in that kind of right shoulder softening and down. Right hip kind of going forwards towards target slightly, and you get more in that, as I say, that sort of frisbee position. I'm going to throw a frisbee from here, we'd naturally create an angle in your body. Yeah, you wouldn't sort of stand there and go, I'm going to throw it here now, because you're naturally just picking up in the air. So we can get in that slightly tilted position, okay? If you just watch the back, so this is the one on the left where you're a bit sort of more leveled off, as we said. You can see as you go back now, quite a lot of your spine angle at that position, your hips kind of gone outwards this way, that knee's gone a long way across, there's a very tilted collapsed position there. Well, that's going to, if you shaft lean from there, it's going to go over there somewhere. So your only response to that now is to try and throw the club over the top, or try and throw the club at it, do something to try and square the club face up. Yeah. Whereas on this one here now, as we go back, it's a little bit longer than I want to see in terms of the backswing. That would be ideal, but look at your spine angle there. Mm-hmm. That for me is okay in an ideal world. You want your spine angle to be almost the other way. I mean, if I'm going back here now, I'm kind of going a bit more this way, not that way. Yeah. But that hip's always going to go to the right if you set up very level. You try and turn your hips now, it just doesn't really sit well with your body. You're kind of like, don't really want to do that. So if we get that right hip sort of in under your shoulder this way, now your hip can turn inwards and back around, the shoulder can work better. It just gets you in a better position. Your lower half there, you can see, I mean, just look at those two positions there with your lower. You've got much more stability. There's daylight between your knees there, where that one sort of really collapsed. Your spine angle, just looking at that there, how much more tilt you've got on this left-hand one. Yeah. And then because of that now, at least if you're in a better position here, you're able to come back to the golf ball and utilize that kind of shaft lean and get the good contact. If you're having to sort of fight the club being over the top, having to sort of flick it with your hand, well, you're just going to have to flick the club face. So your impact's going to look more that way to try and square the club face. Because if I'm from here now, very steep, hard to sort of square the club face up, I'm going to come in this way, shaft lean. So now I square the club face up, I'll do that, which can tend to lead to thin shots. Because your hands are behind the ball, you know, maybe behind the ball sort of shots, just sort of scoopy, thinny ones. It might get some high floaty ones, but in your case, that sort of thinny low shot's going to be more prevalent, rather than if we can get that sort of, again. And I think in terms of practice, can you go to range at all? You don't need people on the range if you can. Yeah. If you're down the range, set up on the range, and that sort of massive hooky one you hit, right, so that'd be great for around the trees. Hit your first 10 or 15 shots, really setting up as strong, as tilted, as underneath as you can, and it just hit like 50, 60 yard hooks as your warm up. And then we got big shots, maybe like a wedge or a 9-9, and just see how much you can hook it, okay? So then you start seeing a ball flight going this way. Your brain's going to start seeing that and start trying to almost start it further right for you, because your straight, shall we say, is somewhere to the left. Okay, if you put some lines on here now, if you think this here is the blue line's a target line, okay? Your kind of straight line to that, to target, is that green line there, okay? And when the ball then starts curving this way, we go to a yellow line, you start trying to swing it further left, okay? If your first four or five shots on the range, okay, look like this, well then you go, hang on, I want to start the ball further this way. So you'll just start naturally creating this sort of angle in here, doing this more, because you've got a stronger club face, you've got a more powerful impact position, and then starting it out to the right or more towards target will be certainly more easy to do, rather than being up here and thinking, oh, I don't want to go right and trying to come across it. So use those first, I don't know, 10 or 15 balls, and just try and sling as much as you can. Really get a big shoo, that just gets that visual in your head, so you can start seeing that golf ball. Because the one after you at that massive hook, the next one's actually a pretty decent shot. Then because it cut a little bit, you're then trying to cut it more and further right, okay? So it's getting that feeling of what the club face feels like when it's strong, square, and in the right shaft lean, not, I don't want to go right, hands back here, trying to flick at it, yeah? Okay, mate? Make sense?